the greatest American alive.
It's really easy to be confused in a world where no one tells the truth. This thing can be really hard. Project Daddy is divorced, yes. And so based on the circumstances, I'm a summertime daddy. So I had my babies over the summer. I had them for like 2 months and it was amazing, right? And then all of a sudden, school rolls around and it's time for them to go back with their mom. And they go a week early and I wasn't ready yet. I'm not mentally prepared to say goodbye to my babies. I watched all three of my children be born. Project Daddy stood there and I actually pulled my babies from the womb. There's an emotional attachment to my children, yes? And so trying to mentally prepare to say goodbye to my babies, it was tearing me up, but I had to hold it together, you know what I'm saying? Because I need my babies to see me strong. And like I said in the beginning, it's really hard when no one wants to tell the truth. You know, it's easy to be confused. And we want to put on this facade of strength and like there's nothing that bothers us, you know? I have so many friends who are suffering in silence. They won't tell the truth about the thing that's hurting them. Like, they'll talk about it one time and they try to pretend like it's okay, but they don't get any help, you know? Project Daddy is fortunate enough that he's a veteran, and so I can go to the VA and see a therapist, see a psychiatrist, see a psychologist. Hey, the fastest way to get help in America is self-mutilation. And that's not me advocating anything bad. I'm telling you the truth because I've been through the system, yes? But nobody wants to tell the truth, okay? But when you go through it, they won't have a conversation about the thing that's just making you upset. They won't have a conversation about the thing that's bothering you. When you pulled your children from the womb and then you have your children snatched from you and you don't have access to the thing in which you've made, and then based on your ideology, Project Daddy was raised in the church. And so when you're raised in the church and a man's children are his lineage, are his inheritance, yes? In the Bible, children are a legacy, they are an asset. And all of a sudden in modern America, based on that type of ideology, a child can easily become a liability. All of a sudden, this thing that is supposed to be this person who's supposed to be an asset to me, this person I created, now I have to pay a bill for this child. And I'm like, how can I build wealth when this thing that's supposed to be a liability is now an asset? But I digress. And so it's the summer, right? And so I have to say goodbye to my children. And when my children are gone, all of a sudden, the warmth and the laughs that I had every morning to get my children up and to fix them breakfast, yes, all of a sudden that's gone. And so I go to the YouTube, yes, because you can find anything on YouTube. And I go to the YouTube and I type in fatherhood separation. Nothing at all. And so I look up like a paternal separation. Nothing at all. And I'm trying to figure out, I'm like, man, I just type in father missing his children. Nothing at all. And I'm like, dang, I know that most men want to put on this air, this facade of strength. But sometimes life is hard. And so tell the truth and get some power. Yes, men are human beings too. The biggest, most strongest, toughest person that you know in your life is just a human being, just like you. I was sitting in an airport in Paris, you know, and I was there with a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful girl. And so she tells me that she was nervous to talk to me. And I'm like, why in the world would you be nervous to talk to old Project Teenager? Yes. And so she was like, but you know how I came to talk to you? And I said, how'd you come talk to me? She said, my mom told me that everybody goes number two. And I said, what? Everybody goes number two? She's like, yes, everybody poos. I said, oh, that's a great normalizer, right? So every time you look at someone that you think is attractive, you just picture them taking a big old dump, huh? But that thing that she told me back when I was a teenager, it stuck with me. Because it's a way to normalize people. I don't look at anyone as they're special. I look at everyone as a human being that's going through life just like me. Once I was out of the military and I needed services because I found out that I was this egomaniacal narcissist who had a traumatized childhood of seeing violence growing up in a socioeconomic situation that wasn't the best, to put that long-windedly, right? I grew up in a situation that was tough. And so based on the things that I experienced, based on my life, I responded to the world in a very specific way. As a protector, as an aggressor, because I have to protect myself and I have to be aggressive to make sure that these people, they don't cause me or the people I love any bodily harm. This is a reality in America. This is programming, okay? So I'm setting up the premise of the cognitive behavior of Project Daddy based on ideology and based on living circumstances, yes, to give you a picture of a real human person. And now you have a real human person who really misses his children. and there is no solution. There is no conversation. No one wants to tell the truth to get some power. No one will say, man, I miss my babies, and it hurts a whole lot. The only solution that you have as a dad that sees his children maybe every weekend, every other weekend, and on the summers is smile as big as you can when you see them, and when they're gone and you're by yourself, you cry, and then you do it all over again. And you keep yourself together, you keep yourself motivated, you keep yourself preoccupied, but how in the world can you be preoccupied and distract yourself from these wonderful children that you created? That's a hard thought, a hard concept to grasp. It is. And so when I went on my YouTube and on this journey to try to find information, I was like, the most bestest information to have is honest conversation to tell the truth. Yes, the Project Daddy misses his three children, and it's extremely hard sometimes. And so if we can tell the truth and normalize our lives, then maybe we can have conversations that increase the quality of life for all American citizens. Project Daddy is in love with freedom. That idea has caused me to be a rebel my entire life. If you try to put Project Daddy in a box, I'm going to say no, because that doesn't feel free. That does not feel like freedom. And so when you have a person who can make you do anything, then you have to rebel, especially when it's an oppressive system. But now when it comes to something more personal, like co-parenting with my ex-wife, it could be a very tense situation, especially if both people are pulling in opposite directions. When we were talking, I started laughing. I was like, man, I love my babies more than you do, right? And it feels like that old parable of the two people who are in front of the king, and the one who loves the doll more or the child more, the king says, man, cut that baby in half. And the woman who loved the baby more said, please, ma'am, take the baby and go, because she really loved the child and didn't want to see any harm come to the child. And I told my ex-wife that story. I said, man, I love my babies more than you do. Man, let my babies go. Like I'm Pharaoh or something. Let my babies go. Not Pharaoh, Moses, huh? Project Daddy is the damn Moses of the projects. Yes, please let my people go. Please get these people away from subsidized housing and lead them on the path to ownership. These people have no business living in these roach and rat infested apartments, in which cost you, the greatest American life, the citizen, a tremendous amount of money. These are all facts, but that's a conversation for another day. But I am Project Daddy. My life is not a caricature. I am a real live character. Hear me? I am a real live character. This person you see in front of this camera, hey, there's really air running through my lungs. There's really blood in my veins, okay? Tears really do fall from these eyes. And so when it comes to having a co-parenting relationship with my ex-wife, it can easily be a tense situation. Lots of American couples, lots of American families, they go through so much turmoil because of ego. And I could be egotistical and say, those are my babies, give me my babies right now. I'm stronger than you, I'll take them away. But based on legislation, that's not possible. And so since that's not possible, then you can be bitter. But that woman who created my babies, oh my goodness, have you ever seen a sunset? Tell me, have you ever seen a sunset on the horizon when you're off on a cruise? And it's like one of the most beautiful things that you can ever see. There's nothing more beautiful than reaching into the womb and pulling out your baby, and you see the light in their eyes as they start to cry. Then you look over and you see the woman who created that baby, and the world is perfect. You don't experience perfection and then all of a sudden forget that perfect existed. These moments that we create, these are what makes us great. You hear me? I don't try to subscribe to nobody's idea of who Project Daddy is supposed to be. Project Daddy is simply an amalgamation of lived experiences. That's it. And based on my lived experiences is how I'm going to interact with the world. And so me seeing a baby come out of my wife's womb, that's equivalent to seeing a sunset or a sunrise on the most bestest horizon on any planet. It's magical. It's magnificent. And that perspective is what gives me the ability to try to co-parent in the best way possible. That perspective is what tries to help me to tell other folk, hey, whatever it is that you're going through, you can get through it, right? But it all comes through collaboration. I just can't talk about collaboration on an economic and political scale. Hell no. You have to have collaboration in your personal life also. You have to have the perspective to know every person you meet is a wonderful individual in their birth. them coming into the world is equivalent to a sunset or a sunrise. It's a magical moment. It is such a rare thing, life. Even if you took into statistical analysis and said there are 7.7 billion people on the planet, there are more stars in our solar system than there are people on the planet. You, the greatest American live, are a statistical anomaly. You are a phenomenon, yes. But right now we're bickering about things that are nasty. Talk like gender wars, political wars, wars over vaccinations. This thing is going to destroy our nation. I'm like, hold up, wait a minute. You're far too powerful to allow this thing to happen. Someone needs to stand up on some pulpit and tell the truth to get some power, to give the American person some power. Hell no, life is a collaborative effort. And even if I don't agree with you, I respect you enough to say you are entitled to your lived experiences. You are entitled to your frame of reference. I owe you that. That's humanity. I owe you the ability for you to be a whole and complete person. And Project Daddy deserves the ability to be a whole and complete person. And so when I go on the YouTube to try to figure out how can I get through this emotional turmoil of missing my three project babies, then, and I don't find nothing, then I know that we're afraid to have honest conversations. I don't know what it is. I don't know how to operate in a world that's afraid to tell the truth. It's so nasty. Everyone putting on these masks. It's like a giant masquerade party. Everyone has a facade. Everyone has an alter ego. And Project Daddy doesn't know how to do that. I really am a father. I really do live in the projects. And this is my real life. I'm telling the truth. You hear me? If I try to narrate my life with a little bit of color, hey, don't blame me. Because I really do live in a situation where when I walk outside, I see despair. And even if I'm not in the projects, when I go into more affluent areas, I see despair. I see people living in a bubble of someone else's idea of who they are. And I can't do it. I can't live in a bubble of someone else's thoughts. I am a free person. There are things that I do not like. There are people that I do not like, and I will not pretend that I like them. Hell, I'll look in the mirror, and if I'm a fat person, I'll say, Project Daddy, you a fat ass person. You need to change this, yes? Is that indicative of all fat people? No, it's not, but my personal preference is for me to try not to be as fat. God dang on, Project Daddy is losing weight. Y'all cheering me on, go Project, go Project, go. Go Project, go Project, go. As if I'm watching Ninja Turtles from the 1990s, Vanilla Ice was doing this thing, and now that's a gimmick. That's not his real life. Tell the truth and get some power. Yes, I believe in the American person. I want to fight for freedom, but no one wants to fight for freedom. Right now, freedom seems to be analogous to people who don't want freedom. They want to oppress you with their ideas. They only think that their way is the right way and your way is the wrong way. And the moment you get to a place thinking that I'm right and you're wrong, you're going to create conflict, you're going to create division. And right now, listen here, on a global scale, can we talk about like the global agenda? China is bigger, they're growing faster, and they have more money, but we have more land and we have more culture. These are all facts, but we won't acknowledge the things that we have in common. We're so divided right now, and I don't know why we don't see that. We have to expel this nasty energy that's destroying the American person. Project Daddy is a political theorist from the projects. You hear me? I can see the division not only in my own area, but also throughout my city, Houston, Texas, the fourth largest city in the United States of America. In the United States of America, I live here. I can't pretend like I'm finna go somewhere else. I'm not finna go to any other continent. I live on the best place on earth. And why is it the best place on earth? Because you live here. The greatest American alive lives on the best place on the planet. Yes, we have to have better conversations. We lack courage and we lack imagination. So I want to tell you, get some courage and get some imagination to tell a better story. And if your story ain't the most best as hell, man, I tell you what, on Friday, I'm going to see my babies. And when I see them, it's going to be like the sunrise. And my eyes are going to light up and I'm going to see their big beaming faces. And when I have to say goodbye, I'm going to say goodbye, and it's going to be like the sunset. But I know that the sun will rise again. I might shed a tear. That's a magical moment to see the sunrise, to see my babies and have to say, hug and kiss them and say goodbye. Project Daddy might shed a tear, maybe two. But I had to make this video for everybody, for every parent who has to say goodbye to their child sometimes. I know that life can be tough, but in those toughest times, you better know that it's normal, man. everybody takes a dump. And if you're not divorced, if you got to drop your child off a daycare or at school, you might shed a tear too, because that sunset happens for us all. It's the great normalizer for us parents. Yes, and Project Daddy is most certainly a parent. And so I can empathize and be compassionate for whatever it is you're going through. I can understand whatever the American person is going through and tell you that we're going to get through this. And if we have honest conversations, we'll get through this together. I'm Project Daddy, and I want you to leave a comment, subscribe, and come and tell me your story so I can engage in conversation with the greatest American alive. You are the greatest American alive.
The greatest American alive. The greatest American alive. The greatest American alive. The greatest American alive. The greatest American alive.